Hi, I'm Christopher from the Google Cloud Autoscaler team. In this tutorial, I'm going to talk about how to build scalable applications on Google Compute Engine using the Compute Engine Autoscaling and Load Balancing services. The Load Balancing service lets you distribute traffic across many virtual machines, while the Autoscaling service ensures that there are always enough virtual machines to handle any increase or decrease in load. By the end of this video, you will know how to create a simple scalable service using both Autoscaling and Load Balancing. First, we'll set the stage and discuss a scenario where user requires to scale the application frontend. Then we'll go over how Compute Engine can address some of these needs. Finally, we will run some actual examples. Now let's get started. Imagine you're a developer who has just built a new web application and you're about to launch it. Let's assume that your application consists of the following components: a frontend web server with an external IP address associated with your service, a backend server handling all of the business logic and computation for the application, and a persistent storage, such as a MySQL database, where you will store all permanent application data. So you have your serving infrastructure running and are now receiving requests from your users. As the user base and traffic to your application grows, your frontend running on a single instance will soon reach its capacity limit. It won't have enough CPU power to process more parallel requests coming from your users. However, since the frontend of your application is a stateless server, it can be replicated to multiple virtual machines to handle many simultaneous requests. Knowing this can help address potential serving capacity problems. If you provision more frontend instances and hook it up to your backend system, you can serve more requests in parallel. Of course, the backend instance could be scaled in a similar way as long as it is also a stateless server, that is, if all persistent state lives only in the database. We now have more capacity and no requests should be dropped. There is one issue, however. Right now, you have multiple frontend servers, each with a distinct IP address. So you have enough capacity to serve the user traffic, but you need a way to distribute it across these servers. What you need is a single IP address for all your users to connect to. To do this, you can set up a network load balancer, which exposes a single external IP to the world and forwards the traffic across multiple frontend instances, ensuring your instances experience uniform load. As the traffic to your service increases, you would keep adding frontend servers so that the serving capacity can always handle the observed traffic. While this process may work well in the beginning, you might begin to notice that the volume of incoming traffic varies depending on time of the day. You also notice that on some days, you have more traffic than other days. While you keep adding machines to be able to serve the maximum number of user connections, you quickly realize that you also want to remove servers during periods of low traffic. So, in fact, your serving needs look roughly like this. And you could save money overall if you added and removed servers in response to changes in traffic, rather than maintaining the maximum number of servers all the time. Here is where an autoscaler can come to the rescue. Instead of keeping track of traffic and adjusting the number of servers manually, you could configure Autoscaler to do the job for you automatically. An Autoscaler constantly keeps track of how busy a group of instances are by watching the utilization level of instances. You define what utilization metric the Autoscaler watches, such as average CPU load, and define a specific per-instance utilization target, and the Autoscaler automatically works to maintain this target. For example, you might set the utilization target of your instances at 60% CPU utilization. When the CPU utilization exceeds this target, the Autoscaler adds more instances to handle the load automatically. Let's assume you have one instance receiving one request per second, which consumes 30% of the CPU on the machine. If the traffic suddenly grows to 3 requests per second, the machine will run hot using 90% of CPU. At this point, the Autoscaler will add as many instances as necessary to get below the target utilization, which in our example is just one extra instance. With 2 instances, the load drops to 1.5 requests per second per instance, and the CPU utilization drops to 45% on each instance, which is below the target 60% utilization that we defined earlier. If the utilization remains low for a long time, and it is possible to keep utilization below the target with a fewer number of instances, Autoscaler will start removing instances. Now that we have defined our scenario, let's go over the configuration steps you would need to set up your resources like we just described. First, you need a group of instances. To create it, you must define an instance template which describes the image, machine type, startup script, and other properties of the virtual machines in the group. This template will be used to create new instances in the future as well, either by the autoscaling service or if you manually add a new instance to the group. Then create your group of instances. Use the instance template from step 1 to create a managed instance group, which contains any number of identical instances. Once you have created the managed instance group, you can enable autoscaling for the group. Finally, create the network load balancer to handle traffic from a single external IP. The network load balancer talks to a group of backends called the target pool. A target pool can contain individual instances or groups of instances. In this case, it will just consist of the single managed instance group you create. The network load balancer uses a forwarding rule, which defines the protocol, IP address, and port the users will talk to. That's it. Now it's time to try it out in practice. We are going to use the developer's console to perform all the steps. We assume that you already have a Google Cloud Platform project set up. For the purpose of this demonstration, we will only create the frontend layer, which will respond to HTTP requests without talking to a backend. Step 1. Create an instance template. Go to Instance Templates pane and choose New Instance Template. At this step, you are selecting machine type, operating system, and disk for your servers. Use the default settings. Give a name to your template and check Allow HTTP traffic. Finally, add a startup script for your VM in the Instance Metadata field. For this example, we are adding a startup script that downloads the frontend application code from cloud storage. The frontend is a super simple web server written in Python, which only simulates the effect of real request processing by running an idle loop that consumes some CPU power in response to HTTP GET requests. In a real application, we would replace this idle loop with some logic to do request processing, communication with the backend, and to generate HTTP responses. The code for this demo is available under storage.googleapis.com/autoscaler-demo/frontend.py. Based on the code, notice that our frontend will serve requests under the path /service, so we will later be appending it to the HTTP address of the frontend. Of course, if you prefer, instead of using the Python app, you could install a standard Apache web server and write a PHP script for a similar result. Step 2. Create an instance group using the template that you just defined and enable autoscaler. Select a preferred zone for your service to operate and give your group a name. The autoscaler configuration is pre-filled with defaults. Here we will use the average CPU utilization of the VMs as the utilization metric to measure. The target utilization is set to 60%. Also, keep in mind that the autoscaling policy can be customized. Instead of CPU usage, you could choose other utilization metrics, such as rate of requests going through the load balancer or arbitrary cloud monitoring metrics. For now, we'll just use the defaults. Click Create to create your instance group. Creating the instance group may take about 2 minutes. Check when the group is ready by watching the Activities tab in the bottom right corner of the screen. To see the details of the instance group, select it in the Instance Groups pane. Here we can see that the first instance has been created. Step 3. Configure Load Balancer. Select Network Load Balancing. You may notice that there is another option called HTTP Load Balancing next to it. This is a more advanced form of load balancing, which offers options specific to HTTP traffic, such as balancing based on URL map. As we don't need these advanced features, we are going to use the generic Network Load Balancing for this example. Go to the Basic Setup tab of the Network Load Balancing page. Under Region, choose the same region where the instance group lives. The Forwarding Rule section specifies the endpoint that your users will send the traffic to. Leave it set to the default options, that is ephemeral IP, port number 80, TCP traffic. Then we define the target pool. Recall that the target pool is the group of instances that the network load balancer will forward traffic to. We choose Select Existing Instance Group and pick the instance group we created in the previous step. That's it. You are done setting up your configuration. You can test your stack by entering the IP address of the forwarding rule in the web browser, followed by the /service path. To get the external IP address of the forwarding rule, go to the Forwarding Rules tab of the same menu. It works. So far, the load balancer didn't have to do much work, since the frontend only had one instance. For a real test, send some more traffic to the instance. Let's run a shell script to send HTTP GET requests to the IP address of the forwarding rule. This command generates one HTTP request every second. The frontend was implemented to consume 1 second of CPU time to serve a single request, so on a single core machine, it will be running at 100% utilization. The autoscaler should start another instance soon to handle the increase in load. Let's return to the instance group page and select our instance group. Here we go. The instance group page now shows an additional instance added by the autoscaler. Let's try to double the load. Simply decrease the delay between the requests to half a second. We should see the response time immediately going up. Some requests are even timing out. In a short while, autoscaler adds another two instances. The response time drops down to normal. I encourage you to experiment more with this setup. You may notice that when the traffic stops, it takes a while before the autoscaler starts deleting instances. This is to reduce disruption to the service and to avoid the cost of frequent restarts of virtual machines. We hope that this presentation demonstrated how easily you can start building your own scalable applications with Google Cloud Platform. Autoscaler is designed to work equally well for Google Scale applications running on hundreds of virtual machines to let you take full advantage of the Google Cloud Platform scale.